St. Vincent de Paul was a very creative mind. He had the capacity to shape good ideas into creative forms, many of which had lasted for hundreds of years. In 1617, in order to meet the desperate needs of the poor of his parish, he founded the Confraternities of Charity, which exist as International Association of Charity. Today, there are more than 260,000 members in 45 different countries. In 1625, after the preaching in Folleville, Vincent, inspired by Madame de Gondé, started the Congregation of the Mission to evangelize the poor. Today, all over the world, more than 4,000 priests continue the same mission. The Daughters of Charity were a revolutionary foundation in 1633. St. Vincent was able to do what Francis de Sales and others were unable to do. St. Vincent and Louis fashioned this new type of community slowly and steadily, avoiding the canonical bonds that kept women enclosed in the cloister. Today, they grew up as the most numbered women congregation in the world. Vincent was one of the greatest reformers of clergy in 16th century in France. He took part in the Council of Conscience for a decade. Many of the spiritual leaders of his time were regularly attending the Tuesday conference which he organized. During his time, more than 12,000 priests made retreat at Saint-Lazare. Let us reflect upon Vincentian family. Vincentian family comprises organizations inspired by the life and work of Vincent de Paul. He directly founded Confraternities of Charity, today known as AIC, Congregation of the Mission, and Daughters of Charity of Vincent de Paul. Frederick Osana, inspired by a daughter of charity, Sister Rosalie Rendu, founded the Society of St. Vincent de Paul, known as SSVP. Today, identified some 268 institutes that meet at least one criterion as members of Vincentian family. What we are trying to say is this: creative beginnings are usually recognized only later when they have grown into full-scale creative works. The seed is beautiful only in the flowering tree. So we say to you today, sow many seeds. Let your ears be open, as were the ears of St. Vincent, to new ideas. Take them and use them yourself. Support new initiatives of others. In these challenging times, encourage creativity and be courageous, and persist in putting creative ideas into practice.